Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today we dive into the fascinating world of the 2003 superhero movie, The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, also known as The Extraordinary League. This movie is a unique blend of action, adventure, science fiction, and a touch of Victorian-era influence. The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen is a group of British and colonial secret agents, employed by the British government until the mid-20th century, dedicated to protecting England from threats, both earthly and paranormal. The movie was directed by Stephen Norrington and starred a renowned cast, and despite its potential to kick off a new franchise, it failed to impress critics and plans for a sequel faded away. However, that does not prevent it from being a fascinating topic to explore. In today's video, we'll take a closer look at each character, from Alan Quatermain to Dorian Gray and beyond, examining how they were reinvented, their stories, personalities, as well as their powers and abilities. Mina Harker, formerly known as Mina Murray, is a character who once walked among mortals. Initially, she appears as a young teacher engaged to Jonathan Harker, who becomes deeply involved in the sinister events related to Count Dracula. After being victimized by Dracula, Mina acquires vampiric traits, including immortality and superhuman strength, but she strives to maintain her humanity. In Bram Stoker's original tale, Mina is portrayed as a resilient woman who survives Count Dracula and continues to lead a seemingly normal life with Jonathan, with whom she has a son named Quincy. However, her life takes a darker turn in other adaptations. Her encounters with Dracula instill a mix of fear and fascination, with her vampiric nature deeply impacting her and turning her into a capable leader, able to achieve formidable feats and display strategic cunning. Transitioning from her human life to that of a vampire, Mina's powers are formidable. She possesses immortality, meaning she does not age and cannot be killed by conventional means. Her superhuman strength allows her to overpower her enemies effortlessly, and her ability to transform into a swarm of bats or mist enables her to escape or attack with lethal force. Additionally, Mina has a notable healing factor that makes her very difficult to neutralize. Complementing these abilities, she possesses menacing fangs and claws, which transform her hands into deadly weapons. Mina's journey from a Victorian teacher to an immortal vampire demonstrates her internal conflict, struggling with her supernatural powers while adhering to her intrinsic moral compass. This duality is further explored in her leadership roles within the League, where she uses her vampiric abilities and strategic mind to combat threats alongside her other League companions. In the movie, she is portrayed by Peta Wilson, but Mina is not the leader of the League. This role is assumed by Alan Quatermain. However, it is suggested that she is the strategic mind behind their operations. This adaptation also slightly alters her personal history, depicting her as a widow rather than divorced, suggesting a different sequence of events leading to her current state. Despite these changes, Mina remains a figure of great complexity and mystery. Captain Nemo is a sailor from the 1870s novels 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea and The Mysterious Island by Jules Verne. Prince Dakar, also known as Captain Nemo, is an enigmatic figure whose life is marked by adventure, scientific brilliance, and deep-rooted revenge. Nemo underwent a European education before his life took a tragic turn during the Sepoy Rebellion of 1857, where he lost his family and his kingdom. In response, he dedicated himself to scientific studies and built the advanced submarine called Nautilus, becoming a pirate who sailed the seas to combat injustices and support the oppressed, often rescuing treasures from shipwrecks to fund his causes. Nemo, whose name means nobody in Latin, preferred a life of isolation under the sea, emerging only to intervene in global injustices. Despite claiming detachment from the superficial world, his actions often aligned with broader heroic goals. Although it was reported that he died in 1883 on Lincoln Island, Nemo was actually alive and later became involved with the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen in 1899. Motivated by his adventurous spirit and technological prowess, he formed an ironic friendship with the British imperialist Alan Quatermain, highlighting his contradictory personality, capable of collaborating with former adversaries for a greater cause. Throughout his adventures with the League, Nemo combated threats such as Fu Manchu and Professor Moriarty, and faced a Martian invasion, eventually leaving the league disillusioned when the British government employed bacteriological warfare. Disheartened by the government's tactics and disappointed by the birth of a daughter instead of the son he desired, Nemo's final years were spent back on Lincoln Island, raising his daughter, Johnny Dakar, whom he hoped would succeed him despite their strained relationship. Nemo's death in 1910 left a legacy carried forward by his daughter and eventually by his great-grandson, Jack Dacre. In film adaptations, Nemo is portrayed by Nasiruddin Shah, and his character is softened compared to the graphic novels, depicted as more collaborative and less hostile toward his English companions. This adaptation also introduces elements that combine his Sikh origin with broader Hindu traditions, though it simplifies his complex personality seen in the comics. Nemo's portrayal in various media often overlooks the nuanced description of his character in Jules Verne's novels, where his Indian heritage and motivations are more deeply explored. The adaptation efforts by Alan Moore and Kevin O'Neill in the comics sought to align more closely with Verne's original vision, emphasizing the cultural and ethical complexities of Nemo. Alan Quatermain, portrayed by Sean Connery in the film, is an adventurer and elephant hunter from Henry Rider Haggard's novel King Solomon's Mines, and famous for his exploits in Africa. Born around 1825, Quatermain is known for his deep connection to Africa, where he grew up under the guidance of his missionary father and adopted the continent as his second home. His life in Africa was marked by both personal tragedies, including the death of his son, and high adventures, with encounters with native tribes, lost civilizations, and legendary creatures. Quatermain's early life involved extensive travels and adventures across Africa, where he often engaged in big game hunting and participated in various expeditions. One of his significant adventures includes the search for the legendary King Solomon's Mines. Tragedy struck when his son died following an expedition, leading Quatermain to retire to Kenya, distancing himself from the British Empire. In the film adaptation, Quatermain is initially portrayed as retired and disillusioned, residing in a British hotel in Kenya. He is returned to adventure when Sanderson Reed recruits him to lead the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, tasked with thwarting a plot that could lead to a world war. In this role, he mentors the American Secret Service agent, Tom Sawyer, and forms the backbone of the group's leadership, in contrast to his literary counterpart, where Mina Murray often assumes leadership. Quatermain's character is enigmatic and marked by his colonialist views, but also shows respect and empathy towards Native Africans, advocating for their involvement in their own affairs. His adventures often highlight his survival skills, knowledge of the terrain, and leadership qualities, making him an exemplary outdoorsman who finds comfort and identity in the wilds of Africa, rather than in England's urban expansion. His final adventure in the movie sees him sacrificing himself to save his comrades, marking the end of his journey both literally and figuratively, as this portrayal was also Sean Connery's last film role before his retirement. Although he dies in the movie, in the final scene, a shaman indicates that Africa will not let him die, and he is resurrected. Dorian Gray is the central character in Oscar Wilde's novel, The Picture of Dorian Gray. He does not appear in the comic and takes on the role of traitor that would initially belong to Rodney Skinner. In the original narrative, Dorian becomes immortal after a portrait painted by Basil Hallward ages and suffers the effects of his sinful and immoral lifestyle, while Dorian retains his youthful appearance. This supernatural arrangement arises after Dorian, in a moment of vanity and despair, wishes to remain forever young and for the portrait to age in his place. The portrait ultimately serves as a moral ledger, with each misdeed and act of depravity marking and distorting the painted image. The novel concludes with Dorian attempting to destroy the portrait to rid himself of the burden of his guilt and sins, only to find himself fatally wounded, his body showing the marks of age and corruption, while the portrait returns to its original youthful state. In the film adaptation, he is portrayed by Stuart Townsend, curiously the same actor who played Lestat in Queen of the Damned. Dorian Gray is presented with significant modifications in his story and role. In the movie, Dorian is depicted as a narcissistic and wealthy immortal who once had an ambiguous romantic relationship with Mina Harker. His immortality is attributed to the same magical portrait, which absorbs all physical damage and aging that would otherwise afflict him. Gray plays a prominent role in the story as a member of the League, recruited for his supernatural resilience. However, it is revealed that he has been coerced into betraying the League by Professor Moriarty, who holds his portrait hostage to ensure his cooperation. Dorian's betrayal involves stealing critical objects from other League members, such as Jekyll's potion and elements of Nemo's technology. The film concludes with a dramatic confrontation where, upon being confronted with his aged portrait, Dorian undergoes a rapid and fatal reversal of his immortality, decomposing into a corpse while his portrait is restored to its youthful state. In Alan Moore's universe, Dorian Gray is mentioned but does not play a significant role in any of the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen comics. However, his portrait hangs in the secret annex, suggesting historical involvement with a previous incarnation of the League during the mid-19th century. Moreover, Moore touches on the narrative of Dorian Gray in his erotic graphic novel, Lost Girls, where he is depicted engaging in immoral acts. This character, both in literature and film, represents a complex study of vanity, immorality, and the human condition, manipulated in various adaptations to explore themes of eternal youth, moral corruption, and the ultimate price of vanity. Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde is a character from Robert Louis Stevenson's novel, The Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Dr. Henry Jekyll, a Scottish scientist, embarks on a dark journey by experimenting with his own psyche, leading to the creation of his violent alter ego, Mr. Edward Hyde. Originally from Edinburgh, Jekyll is a well-regarded individual known for his kind behavior. However, tormented by his darker impulses, he develops a potion that splits his personality into two distinct identities, the benevolent Dr. Jekyll and the malevolent Mr. Hyde. Jekyll's transformation into Hyde allows his savage nature to dominate, unleashing a series of chaotic events in London. Hyde is initially smaller than Jekyll, symbolizing his nascent evil. However, as Jekyll's moral fabric deteriorates, Hyde becomes stronger and larger, eventually dominating Jekyll without the need for the potion. Jekyll finds himself increasingly marginalized as Hyde becomes dominant, especially under stress or anger. Dr. Jekyll is recruited into the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen to combat various threats. His alter ego, Hyde, plays a crucial role in their missions, including a brutal confrontation in Fu Manchu's lair and a strategic assault on Moriarty's airship. Hyde's monstrous strength and lack of inhibition make him a formidable fighter against the League's enemies. During a Martian invasion, the transformation becomes permanent, and Hyde takes complete control. Showing a rare act of heroism, Hyde sacrifices himself to prevent the Martians from crossing the Thames, ultimately leading to his death. As a tribute, London's Serpentine Park is renamed Hyde Park, and a statue is erected in his honor. His remains are later displayed in the secret annex. In a futuristic scenario set in 2164, Hyde is resurrected from his skeleton, displaying more sober and controlled behavior, fighting alongside the League against the Martians. Despite his violent nature, Hyde develops a complex relationship with Mina Murray, showing moments of genuine care and affection. His character evolves from purely evil to someone capable of loyalty and sacrifice. Hyde's racist remarks and brutal actions often contrast with his strategic importance to the League. Despite his rough exterior, he earns the reluctant respect of his teammates, particularly for his combat skills and unexpected acts of bravery. The original novel by Robert Louis Stevenson explores themes of dual identity that reflect Victorian anxieties about morality and the human psyche. However, Alan Moore's adaptation in the comic series introduces a more dynamic interaction between Jekyll and Hyde, emphasizing Hyde's growth in power as Jekyll's control diminishes. The story suggests that Hyde's increasing dominance is a reflection of Jekyll's repressed evils expanding, providing a critical commentary on the nature of good and evil within a person. Rodney Skinner is the character of the Invisible Man from the novel by H.G. Wells, with the full name of Hawley Griffin, who appears in Alan Moore's graphic novel. In the film adaptation, the character is named Rodney Skinner, and instead of being the inventor of the invisibility formula, he is simply a thief who stole it. Skinner was specifically created for this film due to copyright issues with the 1933 Universal film. He is presented as a gentlemanly and troublesome thief who has stolen an invisibility formula. Unlike Holly Griffin, the original Invisible Man from H.G. Wells' novel, who descends into madness and criminality, Skinner uses his invisibility primarily for theft and maintains a lighter and more loyal character. He speaks with an accent and typically wears a long leather coat, a hat, and dark glasses, using white paint when necessary to make himself visible. Initially distrusted by his peers due to his invisible nature and uncertain motives, Skinner is suspected of being a traitor. However, as the story unfolds, he demonstrates his heroism and loyalty. In critical moments, Skinner provides essential guidance to the League's headquarters about the villains, undertakes dangerous tasks such as placing bombs, and even saves Tom Sawyer from a deadly situation, suffering severe burns in the process. His actions earned him the praise of Alan Quatermain, who acknowledges Skinner's discreet heroism. In contrast, Holly Griffin in Wells' narrative is a talented but troubled scientist who achieves invisibility at the cost of his sanity. His descent into madness and subsequent acts of violence starkly contrast with Skinner's more benign use of invisibility. Griffin's story ends tragically with his murder, which sharply contrasts with Skinner's redemptive arc in the film. Skinner's abilities and cunning play essential roles in several League missions, demonstrating his importance despite initial suspicions about his character. His ability to become invisible makes him an invaluable scout and saboteur, significantly contributing to the League's operations against their adversaries. Tom Sawyer is taken from Mark Twain's novels and is not part of the original comic cast of the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. The film's plot portrays Sawyer as a young man and an American Secret Service agent sent by Theodore Roosevelt. Tom Sawyer is never mentioned by name in the film. Instead, he is referred to as Agent Sawyer. Added to the ensemble to provide an American counterpoint to the predominantly British cast of characters. This inclusion, not found in Alan Moore's original comics, was intended to give the film broader appeal, especially to the American audience. His role as a government agent in this narrative brings a youthful yet competent dynamic to the team, recalling his ingenious and daring nature as a boy. Professor Moriarty in The Phantom of the Opera is the criminal mastermind in the movie and is the most famous antagonist of the detective Sherlock Holmes. He originally dies in Arthur Conan Doyle's novel, The Final Problem, but just as Holmes survived the fall, it is easy to imagine that Moriarty also survived. James Moriarty, famously known as M in the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, emerges as the main antagonist, skillfully blending his roles as a notorious criminal mastermind and the head of British intelligence. This complex character, originally conceived by Arthur Conan Doyle as the archenemy of Sherlock Holmes, is intricately intertwined in the story as a central figure in the formation of the League and its subsequent actions. James Moriarty was an exceptionally talented individual who joined British intelligence during his university years. Recognized for his mathematical genius, he eventually becomes a key figure in espionage, managing criminal activities through a persona created by MI5. This double life leads him to become one of the most influential crime lords in London, controlling the underworld while maintaining his professor identity. His complexity deepens as Moriarty himself begins to question which of his personalities is the real one. Moriarty's criminal enterprises inevitably put him on a collision course with Sherlock Holmes. Their rivalry culminates in the legendary confrontation at the Reichenbach Falls on May 4, 1891. Where Holmes is believed to have ended Moriarty's criminal career by supposedly sending him to his death. However, Moriarty survives with the help of his associates, deepening his resolve and cunning. Surviving the fall, Moriarty rises to the position of director of MI5 under the alias M. He uses this position to form the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen, a group of unique individuals gathered to face threats against the Empire, particularly those of a supernatural nature. His strategic foresight is evident as he orchestrates the recovery of the stolen Cavorite, essential for airship technology that poses a threat to both national security and his criminal dominance. Moriarty's machinations as M involve using the League to secure the Cavorite from the Doctor, another rival criminal mastermind. His true identity and intentions are eventually uncovered by the League, leading to a climactic confrontation aboard his airship. In a desperate moment, Moriarty attempts to secure the Cavorite but inadvertently causes his own death, being catapulted into the sky due to the uncontrolled power of the anti-gravity substance. After Moriarty's death, Mycroft Holmes assumes the role of the new director of MI5. However, Moriarty's impact extends beyond his life, with his strategies and actions continuing to influence events. In the 2003 film adaptation, he is portrayed by Richard Roxburgh, where his character is expanded into a larger narrative involving an attempt to incite a world war for profit, blending his identity with that of the Phantom of the Opera. In Doyle's original stories, Moriarty is portrayed as a shadowy figure looming over Holmes's career, dubbed the Napoleon of Crime. He appears directly in only a few stories, but is a significant presence embodying the ultimate nemesis. The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen adapts and expands his character, transforming him into a formidable antagonist whose influence spans the criminal and intelligence realms, orchestrating complex plots that challenge the League and underscore his profound impact on the literary world of villains. Hey, don't go just yet. If you enjoyed my video, I'd love to recommend another one for you to watch.